Hey everybody, Demonic Orchard here, coming to you with a 2,500 point battle report. This is going to be Daemons versus Warriors of Chaos, and more importantly, Zeench Warriors of Chaos. We have a new guy to the fantasy scene in our area, and he was looking to get a game in. It was going to be around his third or fourth game ever, so I thought I would take him up on it, and we kind of went over the rules and had a good time. It was a really great game, and he's a really great guy, so on to it. My lord choice is the Keeper of Secrets, level 4, Eternal Blade, and always striking first. The magic I rolled was Acquiescence. Hysterical Frenzy, and Phantasmagoria. My first villain was the Herald of Slaanesh, BSB, level 1, and he was rocking the Lash of Slaanesh. My second villain choice is another Herald of Slaanesh, and he was level 1 with plus 2 strength with the Lash of Slaanesh as well. My core choices were a big block of 53 demonettes, full command, and the banner swiftness. They're girls, they're fast, and they kill. Lovely. My other choices were my special with 3 nurglings and 3 blood crushers with full command. My rare was a soul grinder with a fire thrower, skull cannon, and 3 plague drones. His list was a sorcerer lord with the dragon helm, chaos familiar, enchanted shield, talisman of endurance, Third Eye of Zeench, Mark of Zeench, level 4 wizard with a dispel scroll, and he was sitting on top of a Chaos War Shrine, all with the Mark of Zeench. This was really his third game, guys, so if you see something he can improve on, please let him know, throw a comment in, and that way we can try to make his list more competitive and maybe more fun for him to play as well. His hero is an exalted hero with the enchanted shield, great weapon, talisman of preservation, Third Eye of Zeench, Mark of Zeench, and he was sitting on top of a demonic mount. So yeah, it was pretty scary stuff, I think. I really don't know. Never really played Chaos Warriors before. The rest of it, he had 20 warriors, full command, Mark of Zeench, 24 warriors with the Mark of Zeench, with a full command, 12 more warriors, full command, Mark of Zeench. He had 5 Chaos Knights. I bet you're wondering what the mark was. It was Zeench. And a Gore Beast Chariot. What mark? Zeench, and a Muleth Vortex Beast. No laugh, I'm not the tremendous one. So, on to deployment. Here we go. He put his beast on his far right flank, and he had his war shrine next to that. Then he did warriors, knights, and a Gorbish Chariot. My deployment, up in the left-hand corner, you'll see a little pink dot. Those are my Nurglings. I threw them up there when they scouted. I was just really wanting to harass the beast. Maybe have it throw its spell at that instead of at my grinder. I don't know. I really didn't know what to do with them this game. So that's what I did with it. My left flank, I had my soul grinder. I wanted it to pretty much anchor that left flank because I figured it could hold up pretty good against the beast. I figured it could hold up against the war shrine with the sorcerer lord. And I thought maybe I'd get my flame attack off. My cannon was set over there strictly to get a shot off at the beast, maybe the war shrine too, and then charge into some knight or some warriors and kill them off. My demonettes, they're usually dead center. I was gonna run right at the warriors, and I didn't care if I held up two big blocks or not. I know that I'm paper. I'm you know, soft like wet paper, and toilet paper at that. But I figured maybe I could hold them up and wait for the cavalry, i.e. the keeper, to show up and wreck face. My plague drones were going to go at his knights. That's why I lined them up right across from him. I thought that if I got to charge him, that maybe they would hold up long enough for me to get my keeper into them as well. Because you'll notice on the right flank, I put my blood crushers and my keeper right there. My idea was to screen the keeper with the blood crushers and try to get the keeper kind of off in the right flank and then just bring him straight down the middle. Hopefully kind of cascading into knights, into warriors, and just going all the way down the line. The Eternal Blade is so huge. I've been practicing with it. I've talked to people about it and posted on forums, and I'm kind of with I'm going to butcher it, but is it Pharrell's? I hate saying people's screen names wrong, but he is a big believer in it, and he kind of got me on board with it too, with some of his explanations. So I don't leave home without the Eternal Blade now. My keeper, it's just, it's huge. He really does just murder face. So here's a better picture of his right flank, which is his beast and his converted war shrine with his sorcerer lord on top of it, and his 12 warriors. And I really like his conversion. It's really solid. And then his center, which is some more warriors, a big block and a big block. And then his left flank, which is another block and the Gorbeast chariot. Whew, so much stuff to kill. My left flank is going to be my soul grinder and my cannon, hopefully going to take care of that beast. My center is my demonettes and the plague drones. And my right flank is my keeper of secrets with the blood crushers. So going in turn one, I did not get to go first. And he pushed it forward because that's what Chaos Warriors apparently do. Which took us right into magic. And when we went into magic, he had 5 spells for the Tzeentch, and he was going to target my demonettes with Gateway. And I told him that it was just too many people, and his best target was the Soul Grinder. If you disagree with me, let me know. But he ended up doing the Soul Grinder, and he put 5 wounds on it, and it hurt a lot. I should keep my big mouth shut. But you got to help new people so that they have fun at least, you know? No sense cheating. So we had nothing else to do, so we go to my turn, and I push it all forward. My plague drones charge his knights. My keeper goes on top of the hill. And where he's positioned, his Gorbeast chariot actually can't see it. And I move my Nurglings into position to harass the beast. Here's a better look at my plague drones into the Chaos Knights. Hoping to hold them up for a little while. Going into my magic phase, I try to get CAC off. I don't know why I bubble CAC. It was so dumb. Should just single CAC, but didn't go off. And my shooting phase, I shot the flame template, and you see how far it went. I'm a dice rolling genius. However, my cannon, sorry for the bloody picture, looks at his beast. I see the beast. I want the beast. I want to wreck its effing face. So I shoot, and you know how this all goes. Oh yeah, I hit the beast. Then I wound the beast, and you know what it is? Yeah, it is. It's exactly like that. It was a sure shot, baby. What? Little beastie boy fun. And a 6 on the wound. And the beast was no more. And there was much rejoicing in Demonville because the beast had struck out. And in combat, unfortunately, my plague drones did not do as well and suffered a wound. So we go to top of 2, and he charged with the 2 warrior blocks in the center, and they failed, and he basically pushed everything else up forward. Here is a couple of photos of that failed charge right there, of the 2 units. The only thing I was happy about was that it put his exalted hero in front, so my demonettes definitely were going to charge that unit coming up. So I felt pretty good about it. They were pretty long charges. He just rolled bad, which is unfortunate for him. He had no shooting, and his magic was a wash. So combat, he does a wound, I do a wound. Honey, it's a military cadence. Never mind. But the important thing is the drones stick. Because we're awesome, and that's what we do. Going into my turn, my blood crushers charge his Gorbeast chariot, and yeah, he did that. Almost went off the board, but he was like 2 inches from the edge, which was good for him. A better picture of the bottom of 2. You can see I charged with everything. My chariot, my cannon chariot charged into his warrior unit that my blood, my demonettes hit. My soul grinder charged his other unit of warriors. I really thought that this was where the game was going to kind of break open for me in a good way. But you'll see what happens. Here's a better picture of the plague drones and my keeper charging the side of his knights. They're toast. The demonettes right here with his chaos warriors and my cannon. And the soul grinder. Yeah, I think they're going to get eaten, but we'll see. So on my magic phase, I roll an 11. His wizard takes his leadership test, fails it, rerolls to the BSB and fails it again. His wizard was going to turn into a herald. That was just stupid. It was just dumb to have a fun game end that way, pretty much. So I just took the dice and let him keep his Sork. It was retarded. It's a fun game, so whatever, yeah. So I take my dice and I cast Hysterical Frenzy on my Demonettes. 3 attacks apiece, baby. What? Yeah. And then I cast Bubble Kick. Whoop, whoop. Irresistible. And it kills 3 of his knights. Yes. And I get 4 of his warriors. Yes. The miscast really doesn't do anything to me. I think I rolled like a 7. My herald, as you can see, there's nothing there, kills his exalted hero in a challenge. One shot, one kill, baby. And then they step forward, and then with impact hits and everything else, I still only do like a couple more wounds. He was a saving fool. Let me tell you. A saving fool. He still had 3 ranks left after all this combat. It was crazy. Then we go into my Soul Grinder, and he doesn't even get to swing. The Soul Grinder just gets cut down in the prime of his life, and there wasn't much sadness. And which really sucks is, and I know I played this rule wrong, but it let him overrun in my cannon. I know it's wrong. He should do it on his turn, but whatever. So it happens, and he comes into my cannon, and that's going to be bad. So yeah, that sucked. And his Chaos Knights get creamed by my Keeper, who overruns into the side of his other Knight block, and my Plague Drones reform to face them as well, to give support. So top of turn 3, his Gore Beast. His Gore Beast Chariot rallies, which is really great. And we go into magic. He moves his War Shrine up, and that picture, blurry picture coming down, that is a Demon Prince coming to the table. Because during his magic phase, the Chariot, or the War Shrine does what it's supposed to do, and it elevated a champion to demonhood. Oh, man. Why can't things just go smoothly? Why can't my opponents take the beatings that I'm giving them and take it lying down and not put up a fight? But oh no, here comes a fight. Now I gotta deal with a stupid Demon Prince. But Demon Prince is less than greater demon, at least in mathematical equations. But in games of dice, you never know. So, that Demon Prince is making me kind of queasy. Not gonna lie. Oh, I have a feeling this is gonna suck. Why didn't I just let a Sork die on turn 1 with the stupid 11? Ugh. I don't know. Whatever. And then he went and cast Treason on my Demonettes. I was totally fine with it. I mean, I didn't care if they got the General's leadership. There's so many Demonettes, it doesn't matter at this point. No shooting, so in combat, yeah, that's my cannon, it's dead. He beat me at combat, and I rolled an 11, and it went away, because I'm unstable. Yeah, that's what it says. So, here is the picture of the combat that's going to be, and I just start killing warriors. That's the first round, and this is kind of how it went. We did it, and I didn't get a picture of all the guys I killed, but I think I killed 13 or 14 of the guys who were sitting there. He was down to a couple. He lost combat. He was on snake eyes. He failed. I broke him, ran him down because I killed the unit. His other warrior unit fled. It was just bad dice rolling. And my demonettes hit his other warrior block, which started combat all over again. So my keeper and my heralds and demonettes just murdered that unit. There was a couple guys left. My demonettes ran him down. My keeper stayed where he was at because he had the Demon Prince lined up, and since it was his turn, I was going to get the charge off. So you see, there's me getting the charge off, and there's kind of what all of the bottom of 3 looks like right there. And here is a better picture of my Greater Demon on Demon Prince action. There can be only one. 2 men enter, 1 man leave. I just hope that he's the one that's leaving. God. And a wide angle of this. This is epic combat. I mean, at this point, it was 40k night. Everybody was kind of checking it out. It was a lot of fun. I mean, this is a lot of laughs. We go into magic and roll an 11 again. My magic phases were epic. I didn't even make him roll because I really do think it's stupid in a friendly game that just it could decide so much. So whatever. So I cast Hysterical Frenzy with three dice and I rolled two sixes and I casted Hysterical Frenzy on my greater demon just to be sure that I could kill the stupid demon prince. And of course during the magic phase he rolls the dice and my demon prince or my greater demon takes one wound because of Hysterical Frenzy. I wound myself and I was thinking, is this what's going to happen to me? Oh, I was so dreading it. So I roll for my Eternal Blade, and I roll a 3 on a D3, which gives me 3 to my initiative, 3 to my weapon steel, 3 to my strength. And anybody that plays demons or played against it, that made me like weapon skill 12, strength 9, initiative 12. Are you kidding me? And I was rerolling my attacks. So we go into combat, and oh yeah. Here you go. Bam! Those are the wounds that I push through after I get done with my 10 attacks, because Hysterical Frenzy. Those are all the wounds that are unsaved. That's all the goodness. 6 wounds to the DP, and poof, he's gone. Into this world and out of this world. Thank you, come again. And Thunderdome. Just welcome. Welcome to Thunderdome, biatch! And that's me standing on his model. Ah, so great. Which let me overrun into his war shrine. If I was going to kill the war shrine, I want to do it proper. I want to murder its face in combat. A greater demon can murder a war shrine, I hope, right? I don't know. We're going to find out, though. That's for darn sure. So I apologize in advance for the lack of pictures for turn 4. I really forgot. He had the unit of warriors that rallied on this turn, and his chariot came around the side. You'll eventually see a picture of it. And he obviously had the combat with the shrine and his sorcerer. But we go right into magic, and Hysterical Frenzy goes off on me again. So I take D6 strength hits, and I take a couple more wounds. Go figure. It really isn't that big of a deal. I mean, the game's pretty wrapped up at this point. I just never thought Hysterical Frenzy would do all the wounds to my greater demon in a game. So, with no shooting left, we go right into combat, and my Eternal Blade rolls a 3. Pa-cow! Combat will be fun. And I kill the Sorcerer Lord myself. My two hands and a magic weapon. I know it's a little cheesy, but whatever. I don't care. Don't judge me. So he runs away from combat, and I roll a 12 to chase after him, and I catch him and run off the board. So we go to bottom of turn 4, and my greater demon comes back on the table right there. And you'll see here that my Nurglings move forward, my demonettes turn to face his warriors, and my Bloodcrushers get ready to take his charge from his chariot. And we go to his turn because that was all I had left to do. And he charges his warriors and he charges into my Bloodcrushers with his chariot. Here's a better picture of the warriors into the Nurglings. My Nurglings are in deep poo. Literally. Nurglings poo. Funny. And the chariot makes it into the Bloodcrushers because it's fun to roll dice. And he's going to get to roll lots of dice against the Bloodcrushers. Combat we go, and he kills, he does 10 wounds to my Nurglings after combat res. And another picture of the chariot into the Bloodcrushers. And he does 2 wounds, but I roll 2 sixes and save. What? And I do a wound back, because I'm the man. Or at least that's what I tell myself when I look in the mirror. So, how you like me now? But yeah, I do a wound, and he sticks. So, whatever. So this is what the board looks like at the end of turn 5. I really do apologize for not getting those photos in the other round. The store was actually getting ready to close. It closed at 9 o'clock, and we didn't get started till, I want to say, 7:30. And you'll see in this picture, it's like, this is my turn 5, and I charged his warriors. The combat, he kills a Nurgling base. My demonettes swing back. I killed like 6 of them. He runs and I run them down. So there's that. So we go to turn 6, the last turn. And all that's really left is his chariot and my Bloodcrushers. So we end up doing that combat, and he pushes through 2 wounds on my blood crushers. I push through, I think, 4 wounds on him. He ends up breaking, and when he rolls off the table, and that's that. So at the end of the game, I thought I had a picture of it all, but I don't. He had nothing left on the table, and from the other pictures you can see, all my models were pretty much dead center to the table. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Demonic Orchard here one more time. Thank you very much for watching my YouTube channel. If you like it, don't like it, please comment. If you do like it, hit the like button. It's always appreciated to know that these reports are liked by y'all. And if you want to see more and see when I update, I try to get a couple in a week, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Have a great week and a better weekend.